Good evening to one and all present in the meeting. I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering and Director of Internal Quality Assurance, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. At the outset, I thank the principal and Sridevi Madam, the in charge for the Faculty Development Program, for giving me the opportunity to make a presentation on active learning techniques using case study on the occasion of the Teachers Day celebration on 5th September 2020. I wish the Happy Teachers Day to all the faculty members present in the meeting. And the topic for the present today's discussion is active learning techniques using case studies. In the present day situation, the conventional teaching to the engineering college student in particular is not effective, that we can understand from the university exam result and the placement statistics of any institution. So we require a better learning methodology for the improved learning of the students. I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering. I graduated from Karaikudi Alagupachettiar College of Engineering Technology in 1987, BE Mechanical Engineering, and completed my ME program from Regional Engineering College Trichurappalli in 1992. And awarded with PhD in IC engines from Anna University, Chennai in 2010. I have 32 years of teaching experience in various engineering colleges, and I published 4 journal papers, 6 conference papers and 7 books, and 200 video lectures, YouTube video lectures, and these are all the books I published, and this is the image of the books: design of transmission system, turbo machines, heat and mass transfer, operations research, gas dynamics and jet propulsion, thermal engineering, fluid mechanics and machinery. Also, I have a YouTube channel where I upload the video lectures of the subject and the solution for gate question paper in mechanical engineering for the benefit of mechanical engineering students. So today we are going to talk about the active learning technique. So in the active learning technique, the video lectures also plays a important role. So preparing video lecture and sharing with the students, it is also helps in better learning of the students. So that is the idea. I am preparing YouTube video lectures and presenting to the students. Let us start with a statement by our Swami Vivekananda, the symbol of spiritual domain of India. All power is within you. You can do anything and everything. So this is a positive statement. Everybody should believe that we can do anything and everything. And we, out of our lecture teaching, we have to inspire the students that they can do anything and they have all the power within themselves. And this is another important statement by our former president, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. The purpose of education is to make good human beings with the skill and experience. Enlightened human being can be created by the teachers. So on the occasion of the Teachers Day celebration, the message is important. Enlightened human being can be created by teachers. So we teachers, we can create enlightened human beings. So before we get into the real topic, active learning technique, let us define what is learning. Learning is a process that leads to change, which occurs as a result of experience and increases the potential for improved performance and future learning. So increases the potential for improved performance and future learning. Learning will increase the potential for improved performance and future learning. And I highlighted 3 words. Learning is a process, learning leads to change, and learning occurs as a result of experience. So learning is a process, not a product. So the process takes place in the student's mind. We can only infer that it has occurred from the student's product or performance. So the student product may be project work and student performance may be the test mark. So from the product and the test performance, we can infer, we can understand that the learning has occurred in the minds of the student. So it is a process. Learning involves change. So it should give the change. When there is a learning takes place inside the classroom, there should be change in the knowledge, belief, behavior or attitudes of the student, of the learner. So that we have to keep in our mind. Sometimes we find our students, they enter the first year, leaves the final year without change in their attitude. Very rarely they are leaving without change in the attitude. So there should be change in the attitude by learning. And learning is not something done to the students. Please remember, we are not doing something to the students out of learning, but rather something students themselves do. They have to do on their own, the learning. It is a direct result of how students interpret and respond to their experience. So because of learning, they gain some experience. So out of experience, what they learn, what they interpret from the experience and how they respond to their experience, that is what learning. So learning is a process, learning is a change, learning is an experience to the students which give increases the potential for improved performance and future learning of the student. And this flow chart will explain how the learning is taking place in the minds of the student. So any learning, we take the learning from our sense organs, the new information from the senses. Then they are encoding the information. Then the encoded information will go to the sensory register. So from the sensory register, the information goes to the working memory. And this is what happening in normal presentation. It will go up to the working memory. Then after that, it has to go to the long-term memory. So for in the classroom, the information should go to the long-term memory. Then only we can use it, the student can use it for future examination. So only when the information is available in the long-term memory, they can retrieve it for the future use. But in the first four, there is a loss of information. All the information, whatever we learn, whatever we hear in the classroom, whatever we see in the classroom, that is not getting into the long-term memory of the student. That we have to understand. Now, our role as a teacher, what is our role now? So we have to make sure that the information, what is presented, that is getting into the long-term memory of the student, then only they can use it for the future examination. So that is possible only by active learning techniques. So we understand, we learn by our five sense organs, 1% through taste, 1.5% through touch, 3.5% through smell, 11% through hearing, and 83% through sight. And we remember 20% what we hear, 30% what we see, 50% what we see and hear, 80% what we say, and 90% what we say and do. So we remember more when we say something or when we say and do something. So the students can remember more by saying and doing something. So we have to make the student to remember it. That is, putting the information in the long-term memory. That is what? 80% memory, 80% remembrance. So that is possible when we give the opportunity to the student to say something inside the classroom and do something inside the classroom. Then only we can make the student to remember the information for a longer time, and we can make the student to store more information to the remember long-term memory. Then how to make the student to remember the subject content in the examination, for the examination. So I have a few images. So in all the images, the students are involved in the learning process. So the involving the student in the learning process, it is what known as active learning. So we define active learning. So active learning is anything course related that all the students in the class session are called upon to do other than simply watching, listening and taking notes. So it is not nowadays we find all the classrooms, majority of the classrooms, they are the students are very passive. They are passive listeners. They are just listening to the teacher, just seeing to the teacher, not even taking notes. So that will not help for the learning process. So they have to do something other than the listening, watching and taking notes. So there is a definition, involving students in doing things and thinking about what they are doing. That is what active learning. There is another definition, important definition, precise definition. Active learning engages the students in the process of learning through activities or discussion in a class, as opposed to passively listening to an expert. It emphasizes higher order thinking and often involves group work. So Freeman et al. In 2014, this is the very good definition for active learning techniques. So involving students in the discussion, in the process of discussion in the classroom, that is what active learning. And we teachers, we have some experience in teaching. So we are doing learning, active learning. We are doing active learning in the class. When we ask a question, pose a problem to the students, issue some other type of challenges to the students, tell your students to work individually or in a small group to come up with a response, give them some time to do it and stop them, and call one or more individual or group to share their responses. So when you do any one of these two or all these two in our classroom, in our daily activity, then we are doing the active learning in our class. And you are not doing active learning when you lecture, ask question that the same few students always answer, or conduct discussion that engages only a small fraction of the class. So in the active learning, every student in the class should be engaged, should be actively participated. And we have to, every individual should be given importance, every individual should be given opportunity for do something in the learning, in the classroom. That is what active learning. It is not only a fraction of the top performer or a fraction of students in the classroom involving, discussing or sharing with the teacher. So these are all the active learning techniques. Think, pair, share, concept test, thinking aloud, pair problem solving, brainstorming, visible quiz, student team achievement division, 1 minute paper, note check, writing assignment, active cooperative learning, jigsaw, problem based learning, collaborative learning, project based learning, round robin. So there are many more. If you go to the Google and search for active learning technique, the list goes. So we are going to see few things from the list. I am going to share few methodology how to conduct the active learning in the classroom, and finally I share my experience. I share one of my experiences in conducting, doing the active learning technique in the classroom. And here some of the terms or some of the activities are familiar. Maybe we are doing concept test. So we are conducting test in the classroom, weekly test, monthly test or unit test. So in the concept test, it is focusing on a particular concept. So we focus on a particular concept, maybe at the end of the class or end of 1 week, we teach a concept, we teach a particular theory, and focusing on that particular theory, we have to conduct the test. And brainstorming. So this we normally know, we use in our regular classroom. So you open up a discussion among the members using it for a particular topic. So how to use it for classroom? Visible quiz. So we conduct quiz to the students. How to use it actively in the classroom? So note check. We are checking the students' notes randomly. That is also an activity. Now the note check, we have to involve the students for checking the notes. So we will see some of the activities, procedure for some of the activities. The first activity, think, pair, share. Think about a question and share the response with your partner and share the idea or the response with your other group members. So the think, pair, share is was developed in 1981 by Frank Lehman, and the think, pair, share, it goes like this. So think, the instructor poses a question, preferably one demanding analysis, evaluation or synthesis and gives the students 30 seconds or 1 minute or 2 minutes time to think about and about the concept, about the question and prepare a response. They have to write a response about the question. And after 1 minute or 2 minute, then we can permit them to discuss with their neighbor, pair. So the neighbor student will be their pair, partner. Student then turn to their partners and share the responses, thus allowing time for both rehearsal and immediate feedback on their idea. So every individual, they have one solution and they discuss the solution with their partner, and they will correct or consolidate or share their idea and come to a final solution, final response. Then we ask, the teacher can ask any one of the student or number of students to stand up and experience and share their idea, share the response to the rest of the members, rest of the classroom. So during the third and the last stage, student responses can be shared within the learning team, within the larger group or within the entire class during the follow-up discussion. So think, pair, share, this we can use in the classroom for revision. We can use it for revision. So we can use it for revision of a particular topic. After completion of a particular topic, we can use the think, pair, share for revision of a particular topic. And visible quiz. So the quiz questions, frequently we can use the quiz inside the classroom. I tell you how to use the quiz effectively. So we prepare the question. The planning and presenting the quiz is very important for the teacher. So the quiz questions we have to design well in advance, referring the national level examination. For example, GATE examination, IAS examination, IAS examination, or even the Anna University question paper, referring to that, we have to prepare the questions in advance. And that questions is to be asked in the classroom, so that it will be a well-designed quiz program for the improvement of the student. So present a topic with the lecture notes, ask the students to form teams, give time to discuss on the topic and get things clarified, present the quiz questions one by one. So the presenting quiz questions one by one, this may be using the PPT. If you have PPT facility, you can present one by one and make the student respond to the questions. And if you do not have the PPT presentation facility in the classroom, then you can prepare the questions, the answer sheet you can prepare in advance, you can circulate the answer sheet, and you ask one by one, the questions one by one, and make the student to answer in the response sheet. Then you collect the response sheet, answer sheet, and you evaluate and give the solution in the next class and result in the next class. Ask the individual to answer and no discussion with the team members during the answering, and evaluate and find the individual score and the team score. Next day we can present the individual score and the team score. So the only thing, we conduct the quiz program, the only thing what is missing is it should be designed properly with the important national level examination GATE question. You can refer to GATE question paper, Anna University question paper, or IAS, IAS question paper, and you can refer to it. You can design the quiz program. So it will be of the good questions or standard questions. And brainstorming. So this is the session of brainstorming on a particular topic. So brainstorming is a method for generating ideas to solve a design problem. So for problem solving or even for theoretical discussion, particularly for higher level students or even undergraduate students, we can use the technique. It usually involves a group under the direction of a facilitator. The teacher is the facilitator. The four general rules for brainstorming: establish with an intention. There should be a topic. And the facilitator, the teacher, should see that the discussion should not go beyond. It should not deviate from the topic. Reduce the social inhibitions among the group members. Stimulate idea generation. It increases overall creativity of the group. And the advantages of brainstorming: free thinking environment. It provides the free thinking environment, broadening the solution space, improves your critical thinking and the problem solving skill as an individual and the team. So these are all the advantages of the team members of involved in the brainstorming session. And the 1 minute paper. So this may be new. This concept may be new to you. 1 minute paper normally used in a classroom, maybe after 1 week. So 1 minute paper is a very commonly used classroom assessment technique. It really does takes. It take about the minute, and while usually used to at the end of the class, it can be used at the end of any topic discussion. Its major advantage is that it provides rapid feedback on whether the professor's main idea and what the students perceived as the main idea are the same. So we are teaching at the end of the teaching a particular topic. So we can conduct this activity, 1 minute paper. So you can inform the students, you take a paper and you can ask them to write under three headings. The things what are all clear, the things what are all unclear, and things what are all confusing. So the three headings. So you presented your topic. So based on your discussion, based on the topic, you can ask the student what are all the things clear and what are all the things unclear and what are all the things in a confused manner. You can ask them to write. You can collect the paper and consolidate the information, and you can address the second and the third question. What are the things, concepts unclear, and what are the concepts confusing? So you can clarify these two questions in the next discussion, next classroom. So when we do this, so we can the students will get the confidence. So our teacher is concerning about the learning. So we can freely talk to the teacher and get things clarified for the better learning. So this activity will improve the morale of the students. And think aloud pair problem solving. So this activity can be used for problem solving, and the students useful in problem solving, understanding case study or the text. Have the students get into pairs and designate one pair member as an explainer and other pair member as the questioner. So there are two members in each desk. So one person is an explainer, another person is a questioner. So you present the information, present the problem, give the problem to the student, and one person is acting as an explainer and another person is acting as a questioner. The explainer will explain the problem statement line by line to the partner. So read, explain. So the concept, the data given, information given, everything he will explain. And the questioner will ask questions when the explanation are unclear or incomplete, and to give hints when necessary. So the questioner will get things clarified by asking questions. Then they solve the problem. Stop the students after the allotted time and call several individuals to explain things to you. You ask the student to explain whether the concept is clear, and ask the student to solve the problem. Then ask the solution from the student. Then present the next question. Once you get satisfactory explanation, have the pair reverse role and continue with the next part of the problem solution or the case study. So what the next part, you present the next problem to the student. Now the questioner will become explainer and explainer will become questioner. So reverse the role. So like that you can use the problem solving, using you can solve problems in the classroom by making a partnership among the students. So two members join together and they discuss. One person will explain, one person will question, and they will solve the problem. So that it will give better understanding. It will create the relationship, personal relationship also will be better among the students. And note check. So this activity we are doing randomly, we are doing once in a month or once in a week. This you can involve the student. Student work in pair. So they will summarize the notes. So they have notebook with them. They will summarize the note, locate the misconception, whatever is missing that they can locate, and they can fill the gap in the notes. So they can compare the notes of the neighbor and they can compare and fill the gap. So approximately 3 to 5 minutes, it will take 3 to 5 minutes. So we can do it with the help of the student. So note check will help you to improve the writing habit of the student. And the student team achievement division. So this is another activity, important activity for problem, either problem solving or concept learning, learning a new concept, new topic. STAD stands for Student Team Achievement Division. It is a collaborative learning strategy in which small group of learners with the different levels of ability work together to accomplish a shared learning goal. So it was devised by Robert Slavin and his associates in Johns Hopkins University in 2009. The students are assigned to 4 or 5 member learning team that are mixed in performance level and gender. So if it is a co-education institution, we can combine girl students with the boy students and performance level, good performing students, poor performing students, average, poor average, slow learner, everybody, we can mix it up. So we see that in every team there are mixed group of people. The teacher present a lesson and then students work together with their team to make sure that all the team members have mastered in the lesson. So you present the lesson, you give the printout of the particular topic, you ask them to discuss, debate, clarify, and if they want some clarification, you as a teacher give the clarification. So at the end we have to see that all the team members are mastered in the lesson. So here teacher is not presenting the topic. So teacher is only a facilitator. So he is monitoring the discussion among the students, and we see that the students are learning on their own. And finally, all the students will take individual quizzes on the material, at which time they may not help one another. So after a discussion, you can give some time, 20 minutes time for the discussing or preparing the topic. Then after 20 minutes, you may have some quiz questions, 5 or 10 questions. You can present and ask the student to answer. Here they have to answer individually. And the student's quiz score are compared to their own performance, previous performance, the points awarded to on the basis of the degree to which students meet or exceed their own earlier performance. The points are then summed up for the team score. And this is the STAR technique. So learn together as a team, take the individual quizzes and calculate the individual score and the group score. That everything we have to calculate. So I have a YouTube channel. In the YouTube channel also I shared a activity STAR technique conducted in the third semester mechanical engineering. The video is available. You can listen to the video and learn. And there is a reference paper I have mentioned in the video. So you can refer to that paper and you can use the technique for the learning, active learning of the students. And Jigsaw, it is another technique. Jigsaw is a cooperative learning structure applicable to team assignments that call for expertise in several distinct areas, particularly problem solving, concept learning. And they split the concept into different parts and distribute to the students. So you take a notes concept, you divide into part 1, part 2, part 3, something like that, and divide to students. The students of part 1 are called expert team. And then the member understand, become expert on that part. Similarly, other team. So every team will be the expert team. Then they forming the learning team comprising students from each part of the concept. The team member will explain the part to one another member, so everybody in the team will learn the concept. So this is the expert group. So the notes, now there are 4 expert group. The notes is split into 4 segments, 4 part. So it is given to 16 students. So all the 16 students will have either one part 1, part 2, part 3, part 4. So the students who are having part 1 of the notes will join together. They are called as expert group 1. They are discussing on the part 1 of the subject. Expert group 2, they are discussing on the part 2 of the subject. Expert group 3, they are discussing on the part 3 of the subject. And expert group 4, they are discussing the part 4 of the subject. So you give some time for to discuss and learn the part 1, part 2, part 3 and part 4. Then we rearrange, we form the learning group. Now look at the learning group, again 4 learning groups, 4 members in each, but each group comprises 1 member from each group. So concept 1, concept 2, concept 3, concept 4. So all the members, they are expert in each part, 4 parts of the notes, whatever shared. Now they discuss among themselves, among the group members in the learning group, and all the 4 will become expert on the particular concept. So these Jigsaw techniques are very useful in learning case studies or in learning theoretical concepts. So even for discussing 2 more question and answer, you can have this kind of discussion. So you can split into a number of 20 more questions, you can form 20 expert group. You can share the 20 questions and then you can make the 20 learning group and you can make them to learn. So this is very useful in making the student to learn better the theoretical concept. And the technique, what is this? Divide the student into 5 to 6 person jigsaw group. Appoint one student from each group as a leader. Divide the day session to 5 to 6 segments. Assign each student to learn one segment. Give students time to read over their segment and less at least twice and become familiar with it. Form a temporary expert group and having one student from each jigsaw group to join other students assigned to the same segment. Bring the students back into the jigsaw group and ask the student to present his or segment to the group. Float from group to group observing the process. And at the end of the session, give a quiz on the material and evaluate the quiz program. So, this is the jigsaw activity. And active cooperative learning. And look at the arrangement and how the students are sitting in the active cooperative learning. So, this is also very much important, useful for both the problem as well as the theoretical concepts. Cooperative learning is an educational approach that promotes interaction among the students and a shared responsibility for academic achievement. There is another definition. Cooperative learning procedures are designed to engage students actively in the learning process through inquiry and discussion with their peers in a small group. So, it promotes collaboration, communication and creation among the students. And the bookend model. So, this was developed by Carl Smith in University of Minnesota. And this is the technique very much useful. So, this technique, it was available education technology book long back. So, I am adopting this, using this from my early teaching days. And it is very useful for classroom management. So, the classroom, we have to divide into number of segments. So, advanced organizing, 10 to 12 minutes lecture, volume 1, 3 to 4 minutes turn to partner, 10 to 12 minutes lecture again, 3 to 4 minutes turn to partner and 10 to 12 minutes lecture and finally 5 to 6 minutes summary. So, the 50 minutes you can split up and every time when you make a presentation on your new concept, it should be maximum of 15 minutes. So, first initially you spend 5 minutes initial summary or advanced organizing. So, here you can use the technique called brainstorming. Or you can use the quiz program. So, brainstorming, you can use the brainstorming. Open up the topics, you can conduct the brainstorming and we will review the previous day lecture. So, asking questions, making the student to discuss, 5 minutes maximum, you have to monitor. At the end, you have to consolidate and give a report to the students. Consolidated report, you have to present for maybe 1 minute. Then you have to make the presentation for 15 minutes. So, for today, the students, they cannot continuously listen to the teacher and learn things continuously, not more than 15 minutes. So, after 15 minutes, they are getting diverted. Physically, maybe sitting inside the classroom, but mentally, they are away. So, to keep the students inside the classroom physically and mentally, you stop lecturing after 15 minutes and conduct a quiz program. So, in the 15 minutes lecture, what you can do? You can ask your two important questions. I said already, the questions from NIST question paper, questions from GATE question paper, questions from IES and IFS, IRS question, IAS question paper, that you can consolidate, keep it ready in your lecture notes and you ask the question. Then after that, you give the solution and you go for the next presentation segment of 15 minutes. So, based on the time availability, you can have the another activity. So, you divide, finally you have the final summary or you can have the 1 minute paper at the end. So, you divide the lecturing time 50 minutes. So, that will be very much useful for the better learning of the students. So, the bookend model very useful. You can use it daily in your classroom. So, what are the features of active learning techniques? So, it creates greater student interest and motivation than traditional lecture. So, traditional lecture, lecturer is presenting and students are listening. So, instead of teacher is presenting and students are listening, so we conduct active learning, it creates students' interest and motivation. Involve the student in the learning process, process activities rather than passive listening. So, involving the student, that is very important. Provide more frequent and immediate feedback to the students. So, when you conduct a quiz program in between, we give the feedback. So, that students was doing well, this is the correct answer, that is the wrong answer, you improve, you correct. So, you are giving feedback on the performance of the students. The feedback will be the motivation to the student. And immediate feedback, every day we are giving feedback. Now, we are not giving the feedback at the end of the month or end of the semester. We are giving immediately in the classroom. That will give you a great motivation for the day-to-day activities. Promotes development of student skill in critical thinking. This allows the critical thinking. Improves the writing and the speaking skill. So, you are giving opportunity to the student to write something in the note paper, or you ask the student to speak or tell something to the classroom, rest of the classroom. So, it improves the writing and the speaking skill. Increases individual accountability for learning process. So, when we teachers present the subject and the students are passively listening, there is no accountability. Accountability is only with the teacher. When the students are involved in the learning process, now the accountability with the student. They have to learn. That is what the outcome-based education implies. In the outcome-based education today, what the student learning inside the classroom is important than what the teacher is presenting or teaching. What is the outcome? What is the student will do at the end of the classroom? So, the accountability is with the student. They have to do something useful at the end of the class. It promotes greater academic achievement, breadth and depth. So, breadth means the volume of the information they learn. Depth means the depth to which it is they are learning. Student learn to think about the subject and the topic. So, using the active learning technique, they are learning to think about the subject topic. It provides students with an opportunity to think about, talk about and process the course material. So, improve to recall the information. Contribute to more favorable attitudes towards learning. So, when they are involved, they are become part of the learning process. So, the attitude of students towards learning will improve, will change. Places more emphasis on the teachers becoming a designer, facilitator of learning experience rather than imparter of the knowledge. We are not teaching, we are designing the classroom. We are facilitating the active learning technique inside the classroom. Emphasize student-centered learning. Develops expertise in the collaborative learning and teamwork. And create the sense of community in classroom through increased student-student instruction, student-student interaction and the instructor-student interaction. So, it improves. Student-student interaction, instructor-student interaction inside the classroom with respect to the subject. That is very important, with respect to the subject. And it create opportunity for differentiated instruction. We are instructing in different methodology, differentiated instruction. Reinforces important material, concepts and the skills. Addresses different student learning style. Learning style of individual students are different. So, understanding learning style of the student, it is very important. So, many of the students today, they learn more by YouTube videos. They are in the social media. They learn many things through video lectures. So, you prepare video lectures. That is why I prepared the video lectures. And share the video lectures to the students. Creates personal connection to the material for students, which increases their motivation to learn. Allows students to practice important skills, such as collaboration through pair and group work. So, builds self-esteem through conversation with other students. So, self-esteem. So, what is self-esteem? What do you think about yourself? That is what the self-esteem. So, self-esteem will increase through conversation with the fellow students and the peers. And the procedure for implementing the active learning technique in your classroom. Select the topic or the subject content. Select the activity suitably. Whether the concept is or content is theory part or problem part. Based on that, you select the activity. Plan for the requirement of activity and arrange for it. For example, if you want PPT presentation, you arrange for it. If you want to take a printout of the question paper, you make the printout. If you want to print out the content and make multiple copies, everything we have to prepare. Inform the students about the activity and its importance. Inform them one day in advance or inform them on the day of the activity. Conduct the activity, assess the activity, write down the problem faced and the challenges you experienced by conducting the activity. and you have to prepare a report on it. Write down the methods to overcome the challenges. So again, you have to prepare a report. Why I am insisting on the preparing report? Nowadays, even when you go for NBA or NAC, so the innovative teaching methodology, pedagogy is one part of the evaluation process. For innovative teaching pedagogy, active learning technique, we have to implement the active learning technique inside the classroom. So if you say that I am doing active learning technique inside the classroom, where is the proof? So the proof is your report. So you conduct the activity and making a report. The report you present to the committee members, so that indicates that will be useful. That will be you share the outcome of the activity to the student and document it is properly for future use. So you can use it for future and improve the activity again and again, so that you will become an important teacher to the student. And the student will enjoy your lecture and you yourself personally gain some confidence in the teaching profession. And I present my case study. So the case study conducted on the subject heat and mass transfer for the 6th semester mechanical engineering students. The topic is heat exchanger and the date of activity is 19 to 2020 between 10 a.m. to 12 noon in the seminar hall. And the class 10th, there are two sections. So, two sections I have combined for conducting the activity. The class 10th is 45 and 44. And the number of students present here 40 plus 42. So, the total number of teams are 28 and roughly 3 students per team. And I explained about the team formation. So, team formation, I find that the 3 members are there in the team. And minimum one member will be above average student in the team. So we see that and rearrange the student. So in such that at least one member is better student in the team, so that he will take care of the learning of the other 2 students. And we have to give instruction about the team behavior, how they have to behave as a team member in the team. And general code of conduct during the activity, we have to explain, because the activity is conducted for 2 hours. And we have to prepare the question. So this is the question paper circulated to the students, and there are 5 questions. All the 5 questions they have to answer. So you have to prepare the answer. So we circulate the answer paper to the student. They have to, as a team member, each team they have to prepare a set of answer. One set individually, not individual. The team, every team has to prepare the answer. So one student will be reading the problem. One student will be taking the information from the data book. One student will be writing, and like that it goes. So when you observe the classroom, so all the 3 students involved in one activity in the learning process. And this is how the students are arranged in the learning during the active learning technique in the seminar hall. 3 students sitting around the table, and they are involved in solving. The one person is writing, one person referring the data book and reading the information. So it goes like this. Then this is the result of the team members. So each team, A1, A2, A3 up to A14, and C1, C2, C3 up to C14. There are 14 teams in each classroom, and the marks are given out of 50. 5 problems, each problem 10 marks, and 5 out of 50 the mark is given. And A section, one team less than 725. 25 is the pass mark, and 2 teams with a lower mark. And in the section C, there are 3 teams with a lower mark. And this is the average, the report. Highest score 48 in A section, C section 44. Lowest score is 12 and 0. Average score is 36 and 30. And this is statistics will help you to understand about the class and to plan better for their, improve their performance. And this is the report I prepared. Once the instructions were given about the role and what is expected from them, they were calm and focusing on the problem solving. They were actively discussing and solving the problem. I went around and assisted them when they asked doubts. The number of teams scored below average is 10 out of 23. Once they understand the power of peer learning, they can do better. So few students who were absent regularly in the class are combined with a good student to learn from them. And this is the feedback. I told the student to write the feedback after distributing the paper, after correcting and distributing the paper. I told the student to give their feedback, and this is the feedback written by them. I have given 2 samples here, and I have consolidated the feedback from the students. So this type of activity improves our team working skill. It helps us to improve our leadership quality, This activity helps us to share our knowledge with our team members. By solving the problem with the team, we can cross-check the values easily. By working as a team, we can reduce the time to solve the problem. Useful for revising the topic. Got clarity in procedures of how to solve the problem. It is helpful for the slow learners to clarify their doubts. Easy to clarify the doubts. Grouped interaction improved while discussing. Presentation of data is improved. Helps to remember the formula for the group members and easy for examination. So these are all from the mouths of the student. I have just consolidated. So look at the statements, and the students, they are very much benefited by doing this activity. So what do you think about the presentation, about the active learning technique? Somebody may think it is difficult to conduct the active learning technique. Somebody may say, I will try to do it. So maybe impossible or possible in the situation. And wow, it is a good technique we can implement. It's an excellent technique. We can do it. And when we do that, you will become partners for the student success. So my idea or my suggestion to you, it is definitely possible. Daily you can do bookend model, visible quiz, brainstorming. Once in a week, you can do one minute paper, think, pair, share. One per unit for the theory subjects, you can do student team achievement division, jigsaw or active cooperative learning. One per unit for problem solving, you can do the problem based learning or think aloud pair problem solving. So you can implement. So implement, and all the best for your future teaching. So there is a statement. I conclude with this statement. Mudiyadhu endru neengal solvadhai ellam yaro oruvar engo seidhu kondirukkar. So this is from our scientist president Dr. Abdul Kalam. And believe it, sometimes you may start with I do not, I cannot, I want to, how can I do, I am going to try, I can do it, and finally I did it. So you can do it. So believe in yourself. Finally, a statement by Rabindranath Tagore. A teacher can never truly teach unless he is still learning himself. So you have to continuously learn things, then only you can do teach better. So a lamp can never light another lamp unless it continues to burn its own flame. So remember, we update our knowledge, not only knowledge, the pedagogical technique, that is what the active learning technique. So the pedagogy of teaching, how we are teaching, we know we are teaching, all right, how we are teaching, we have to change, then only you can find some better learning environment inside the classroom. So thank you for watching. Thank you for patient hearing. Thank you once again.